exactly the video we saw first. Where is it happening? The dance we saw. It's happening where? On stage? No. Where? In the village. How? In a circle. That dance is what? Dundumba, right?
Yes.
It's Dundumba. So that fulfills a social cultural function. When that dance is abducted from that place and put on stage, it has a different purpose, which is what? Entertainment. Now, if we think about it that way, how is it different from contemporary dance? I'll let you think about it. But for me, so neo-traditional dance is a form of contemporary dance in a traditional dance repertoire. That's for me. So this is now time when I kind of bridge everything to my body and what I do. So how does all this affect me? So this defines my perspective as and my systems as a contemporary dance artist. What I make as a contemporary dance artist is a hybridized, a quest and a research about hybridization. I refuse to have a dance that kind of says, I am an African, or I am this, or I am that. That identity, I have it in me already. So what I'm trying to say is to respond to the needs of my time right now and try to communicate with a global audience. That's me, you know? So my training history, all that has to play in my martial art training, my soccer training, my basketball training, my sabah training, all those stuff come to play in what I do, okay? It's a neutral space. I believe I can dig into it, okay? The way I teach, I don't want to teach from a neo-traditional perspective. That's why in my class, it's in my traditional African dance class, it's more about what we need to know about the movement, the essence of the movement, the purpose of the movement, the socio-cultural ID of the dance. And then if one would like to adhere to a neo-traditional, you know, dance system, it's also fine. It's not forbidden. Then you know exactly what you're doing and you can be respectful to that. Does it make sense? And this also defines my belief in the coexistence of a form of expression that can speak to a body, to anybody, regardless of their origin. What I'm talking about here is what? Contemporary dance, alongside traditional arts preserved in their right sociocultural, historical, and political context. These are my references. It's now time. If you have questions, you're really welcome to ask them. I'm sure you have. If you don't ask me a question, I'll ask you a question. Yeah.
So I was wondering, like, what is a traditional, like, one of your dance classes, like, kind of like look like a layout?
The layout?
Yeah.
So we come into the class, we have a circle. The circle emphasizes the community. We breathe together. It's a time for us to look at each other in the eye and remember the faces and put a name on it. And then we breathe together, we share energy together, we warm up. And then we talk about the socio-cultural elements, function of the dance. What is the dance? Where is it from? What is the population? What's the ethnicity? What's the language? And what's the function of the dance? We discuss all that even before we start moving. And we come back to those questions every day until we're done with that form. So I teach each movement. I'm not teaching a choreography. I'm teaching movement per movement. And then it's you as students, you're gonna come up with a choreography. That's the way for me to ask you to collaborate and work together. Not only for pedagogical purpose, but also a collaborative and community purpose. That's how my traditional class is kind of laid out. Yeah. More questions? challenges,
yes,
and fight for them. The reason, I mean, fight here is a necessity. It's not a physical fight, but we have, because where I come from, like I said, there's a lot of gatekeepers, you know? And there's like the misconceptions about, you know, what the things are and actually what they are. You know, it's two different things. Like what I think this thing is and actually what I'm doing, two different stuff. So I'm just gonna give you an example. I was in Congo and then, you know, I was there as a contemporary choreographer. So we went to visit, you know, a traditional group, quote unquote. And then after the performance, you know, we had a talk. They said, we're not doing contemporary dance. We're doing traditional dances. And I said, how do you define contemporary dance? And exactly, it's like, oh, that's the European, that European, the Tubab dance, because, you know, when we say, you know, there they call it Mundele. In Senegal, we call it Tubab, which means it's a figurative name for white people, you know. So we don't do Mundele dance. It's the dance of the white people. And I said, okay, tell me what you just danced. What's the name of the dance? Where are they coming from? They couldn't even tell. And what is it serving? So, you know, they couldn't even tell me. So I asked them, don't you think what you're doing is contemporary dance? Because I'm sure where this is coming from is never performed the way it is performed. You know? So it's like this kind of discussion all the time. Sometimes I'm the evil, you know. That's one of the challenges. The other one is where to go to get the right information. That's another challenge. Because the new traditional is kind of spoiling, you know, and putting some biases almost everywhere, so it's really hard to get the right information. You have to go deep into the villages so that you can get what you need to know. Right? Thank you.
Cultural rootedness as a springboard for creativity. So thank you so much.